Welcome back to English class. Today I'll be teaching you your new chapter of English literature, which is chapter number 1, Up the Mountain. What's the name of the chapter? Up the Mountain, written by John Lewis Spirey. Who is the author of the chapter? John Lewis Spirey. Now, in this chapter, you're going to read about the main characters. One of the characters is Heidi. The other character is Aunt Daisy, and the other one, which is another young boy, who is Peter, and the rude grandfather. So you are going to read about all these characters in the story. The story is an extract from the most popular novel, Heidi, which is written by John Spirey. Now the setting of this novel was inspired from the several summers which Spirey and on spent on the Swiss mountains in Switzerland. So the descriptions of the vivid sceneries and the landscapes gives it a lively picturization. You can see the scenery which he has used, which the setting which he has used in the story is inspired from the summers which he spent on the Swiss mountains. So let's start. Okay. One summer morning in June, two persons were climbing up the mountain. One of them was a lady. Her name was Aunt Daisy, and she was having a young girl. She was carrying a young girl who was 5 years old, who was a girl of 5 years. Her name was Heidi. What was her name? Heidi. So they, both of them were climbing up the mountain. Now the question is, how this girl is related to that lady? Now this girl, Heidi, is an orphan. Her parents passed away when she was born. So since then, she is being brought up by Aunt Daisy. She is looking after this girl. So she has got some work. She has been bringing up the child very well from the past 4 years. But suddenly something happens, after which she decided that she will be leaving the child now to her grandfather. The grandfather was very rude. Now let us see what happens in the story. So both of them were climbing up the mountain. The girl was wrapped in so many clothes. She was wearing double-layered clothes. She was wrapped in a shawl. She was wearing stockings. She was wearing mountain boots. Because Aunt Daisy wrapped her in so many clothes as they were climbing up the mountain. And on the mountain, the weather, the climate is very cold. So she wrapped her in so many clothes, but the girl was not liking it. She was not finding it comfortable to walk with so many clothes. She was overburdened by the clothes, so she was not finding it easy to walk. Now when they were walking, the girl asked, "Are you tired, Heidi?" The girl replied, "No, I'm not tired. I'm hot." Means she was feeling very hot. She was feeling suffocated in those clothes. So she said, to console the girl, she said, "Soon we'll reach up the mountain. So don't worry. Take brisk steps. Take quick small steps, and we'll be soon reaching the top of the mountain." Now, as Aunt Daisy was walking forward, the girl was lagging behind every time because of her overburdened clothes. Now, when the girl was behind, she saw a young goatherd there far in the mountains. The name of the goatherd was Peter. He was taking his flock of goats and sheep for the pastures up the on the mountains. So the girl tried to she was trying to follow that boy. Instead of following Aunt Daisy, she ran towards the boy. She ran towards Peter. Now when she saw, she was unable to walk because she was wearing so many clothes, she was wearing boots, she was not able to walk properly. When she saw that the goatherd was in simple clothes, in fact he was walking barefoot on the grass, she thought that why not to remove all her clothes. So she unwrapped her shawl, she removed her first layer of cloth which she was wearing, after that she removed the second, and in a few seconds she was in her undergarment, simple, and after that she was free and jumping like a goat, and soon she caught the goatherd. She reached to the Peter. After that, when Aunt Daisy looked back, she found that Hedy was nowhere. She was nowhere. She started screaming. She started shouting angrily. Hedy, where are you? Now, what happens next? I'll be teaching you in the next session. Okay? Take care.